So these tri-gate devices were first introduced at the 22-nanometer technology. And I want to make a very profound statement here predicting the future that, you know, going forward, as you know, you go from 22-nanometer to 14-nanometer or 10-nanometer technology. What I'm saying is that these devices will, going forward, will become taller and they'll become thinner. So in a lot of ways, in a very fun way, these devices, these tri-gate devices, they are resembling human nature. Or, you know, as human beings, we all want to be tall and we want to be, you know, we want to be skinny and we want to be thin. So in a lot of ways, you know, these devices, in a very fun way, they want to resemble the human nature, that, you know, as they grow up, as the year passes by, they want to be taller and they want to be thinner. And, you know, that creates a lot of challenges in terms of processing these devices. But, you know, let me try to explain why this is the case, why you want to be taller and why do you want to be thinner. So let me evoke back this analogy that we had used earlier, that, you know, we have two beakers. Essentially, you know, one beaker is the source, which is the source of carriers or electrons, and the other beaker is the drain, which is to collect these carriers. And you have this gate, which acts like a nozzle, which controls the flow of electrons from the source to the drain. So, you know, going forward in technology nodes, as you go from 22 nanometer technology to, you know, 14 or 10 nanometer technology, you will be scaling your gate length. So, you know, currently a gate length of 22 nanometer technology is actually a 30 nanometer gate length. And going forward, you'll be, you know, reducing your gate length to, say, you know, 25, 22, 20 nanometer. So as you are, you know, you're reducing this gate length, as you are scaling your gate, the device, you know, the electrostatics of this device is only maintained when you shrink down this nozzle too. So what I'm saying is, you know, if you are shrinking your gate length, you need to shrink this nozzle width to maintain the same gate control. So to maintain the same effectiveness of this nozzle, you need to scale both your gate length. So as you are scaling your gate length, you need to scale this width of this nozzle, or, you know, you need to scale the thickness of this channel material as well. And let me illustrate this further. So, you know, and this scaling laws actually depend upon the nature of the device. So say a double gate device, it has, you know, pretty decent electrostatics. So as you're scaling your gate length, you need to scale your length of your, as you're scaling your gate length, you need to scale your thickness of this channel material as, you know, 2/3 of the gate length. For a tri-gate device, you know, it has better electrostatic control as compared to the double gate device. So this scaling of this silicon thickness is slightly relaxed. So when you're scaling your gate length, you need to keep your silicon thickness roughly proportional to your gate length. So, you know, going from 2/3, you're actually going to 1. So, you know, you're slightly relaxing on this thickness requirement. For a gate all around device now, which has, you know, even better electrostatics, the scaling law now becomes, you know, you need to keep your thickness of your silicon, or, you know, the diameter of your wire, you know, it could be maximum of twice your gate length. So, you know, you are now scaling with twice your gate length in this gate all around device. And, you know, one of the homework problems, I've right now, you know, simply stated these formula, but, you know, one of these homeworks problems, you'll be actually deriving this, how the T silicon depends, you know, what is the functional dependence on the gate length for all these three devices. So there'll be homework problem where you'll be actually driving this. So, you know, that explains, you know, so now, as you know, as you scale your gate length, you need to scale your the thickness of your channel material. So that explains, you know, why these devices need to become thinner, or, you know, why they need to be skinnier. So, you know, going forward, you would like to scale your gate length because you want to continue your moves, or you know, you want to improve your performance. And so, you know, you need to scale your enable your gate length scaling, you also need to scale your silicon thickness. So that's why, you know, you need to, going forward, you need to make these devices thinner, right? So now, why do you need to make them taller? You know, why tall? So tall is very simple. You know, the taller you have your device, you can pack a larger amount of current in the same area density. So, you know, for example, you have this device, and you know, if I make it twice as tall, you know, I keep my area footprint on my substrate the same, but now, you know, I have roughly twice the amount of surface area. So, you know, the taller I make the device, the more, you know, the more on current I can pack in the same area, right? So on current per area per, you know, it increases. So one way to, you know, enable further performance improvement or enable current improvement is, you know, to keep on making these devices taller and taller. So, you know, these FinFET devices essentially allow another handle to on Moore's law. You know, you can improve your on current two ways. You can, you know, you can decrease your gate length, right? Or you can increase your fin height, right? So both of these demand that, you know, you need to enable to decrease your gate length, you now need to, you know, scale your fin width. So you need to make them thinner, and you know, to increase the on current by increasing the fin height, now you need to make them taller. So that's why, you know, going forward, these devices, what I'm predicting is these devices will be taller and they'll be thinner. And that looks very nice on this cartoon, but it possesses a lot of processing challenges. So, you know, as you can expect, you know, you want to deposit a conformal gate oxide on this, you know, very high aspect ratio fin, or, you know, as you're making them thinner and you're taller, you're increasing your aspect ratio, right? So that introduces a lot of process complexity and process challenges that we'll discuss in the subsequent class.